Okay. Susan, thank you for taking a minute to answer a question about the registration issue in Connecticut. Now, how many new registrations have you received this year?
Since January, we've had 220,000 new voters register in the state of Connecticut. And just in the past 2 weeks, we've had an additional 50,000 voters register in the first 2 weeks of October. So we're thrilled with the outpouring of participation, and about half of those voters are young people between the ages of 18 and 29.
Now, how does the breakdown between the parties, between Democrat, Republican, and unaffiliated?
Of those that choose parties, it is 4-1 Democrat to Republican. So it's, you know, it is nice to see Democratic registration doing so well, and it's like that across the country, actually. And I think that the other side is frustrated.
Now, I understand the Republicans are making a large issue about the ACORN registrations that are gathered, that some of them may have inaccurate information. They're calling it voter fraud. Can you take a second and explain what that is?
Here's why I am not concerned about that issue for Connecticut. First of all, I do understand that the Elections Enforcement Agency may be looking into and investigating a complaint, and that is very appropriate because, of course, in Connecticut, we take any allegation of fraud very seriously and have it investigated. The good news for Connecticut is we have a whole process in place to ensure the integrity of the voting process. The registrars of voters, when they receive voter registration cards without birth dates or without signatures, can't process them. They don't make those people voters. They have to do additional research and investigation. If they don't get a signature, if they don't get a birth date, they can't register the person to vote. If the ID number on the driver's license or the social security number doesn't match, they can't register that person to vote.
So the registrar looks at this individual information and verifies.
The registrar is a filter for bogus applications. And we've had registrars call our office and ask for advice. If pertinent information, critical information is missing, that person can't become a voter. Also, federal law and state law requires that voters show an ID, especially first-time voters in presidential elections have to show an ID. So,
if they register like in person at the registrar's office, they show an ID there.
Absolutely.
So,
and if they're going
a mail-in
and they're going to the polls for the first time, they have to show an ID. So a 7-year-old couldn't register to vote. And therefore, I think our process where our registrars do investigation and act as a filter for bogus registration really takes care of that issue for Connecticut. We have procedures and a process in place to confirm that people are eligible to vote. They have to show ID. Also, there are confirmation letters sent to the people who've been registered, and if for any reason a confirmation letter should come back, that registrar has to do more investigation to see, okay, did we send it to the wrong address? Does that address exist? Is that person really who they say they are? So we have many checks in place in our state to protect against bogus registrations.
So the main complaints then have been coming from Republican registrars regarding the ACORN registration?
You know, I believe that I haven't seen the complaints, but I believe some complaints have been made to Elections Enforcement, and they are the appropriate agency to look into that. But I do think some of this is emanating from the fact that the Republican Party is simply frustrated that Democratic registration in Connecticut and all over the country is up in very high numbers. They're frustrated, and they're just throwing stuff against the wall to see if it sticks.
Well, Susan, always a pleasure. Thank you so much
Thank
for taking this time.
Much.
I know it's been a long day for
Thank
you.
Thank you. Bye.